Abigail is too busy for these wild goose chases, Vancho. She's not a child anymore. She has a town to take care of.
Aye, you just don't want her chasing ghosts.
I love old maps. When I was a little girl, they always led to treasure.
They always make me feel more lost.
My name's Lara, by the way.
Pilar. You don't look like the type of tourists we usually get.
I'm an archaeologist, actually.
Yes, that would be more fitting, I think. You should speak with Abigail. She knows the history of this place better than almost anyone.
We've already met. Abby's been kind enough to let my friend and I stay with her while we're visiting.
Ah, well then, you are a welcomed guest in Kuakyaku.
Thank you. Do you need help understanding the map?
It wasn't meant for me to understand.
I have hidden the truth, as Abigail will find, but to uncover it, she must take a trip back in time.
Mariana was never much of a poet.
Mariana?
Abigail's grandmother. We lost her to cancer 1 year ago today, actually.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Mariana wanted Abigail to have the map on the anniversary of her death, but...
You're not sure?
I don't know if she's ready.
It's none of my business, but if it helps, Mariana believes she was.
You're right. I guess it never was my decision, was it? Would you mind delivering the map to Abigail? You could make a full-time job of chasing that girl around, and my hips just won't have it.
Not at all. Abby, it's Lara.
Hey, stranger. How are you making out? How's Jonah?
Jonah's fine. He's with a friend.
A friend, huh? What's her name?
His name is Uchu. Listen, Abby, I'm back in Kuakyaku, and I've come across an old map that belonged to your grandmother.
Well, there's an old-timer in town, Diego. He runs the community garden. He's into maps, I think. Maybe he can take a look. Meet me there?
On my way.
Can I help you?
I'm a friend of Abby's. She asked me to meet her here. We have a map we'd like you to look at.
Oh, let's have a look. This is a nice piece of work. Good detail. Happy to see it's held up all these years.
You're familiar with it.
Might be a little more dust in the attic these days, but I never forget my work. Abby's grandmother asked me to draw it up. If I remember right, it was supposed to be some kind of gift for Abby.
There are blemishes here, 3 of them, do you see?
I didn't put those there. It smells like lemon, doesn't it?
Lemon? Lemon juice can be used as ink to... There could be a heat-fix message hidden in the map. Can I use your brazier?
Sure, be my guest. So how does this work?
Well, lemon juice is organic, so it will oxidize and turn brown when it's heated, and a secret message will appear.
It's been a lot of years. You think it'll still show?
As soon as Abby gets here, we're gonna find out.
Find out what?
Speak of the devil.
I'm an angel, Diego. You know that.
Not when you were little.
Abby, according to Diego, your grandmother asked him to make the map for you, as a gift.
Why would I need a map of the village? I know this place in my sleep.
There's more. Your grandmother hid something here in the paper. You can barely see it. I think it's a secret message.
She used invisible ink.
Invisible ink? Really?
Well, it's just lemon juice, but...
But it does the trick.
So, what's this secret?
Don't know. May I?
Let's take a look.
Look, those symbols, they're...
Three X's.
X marks the spot.
Cute, Grandma.
Are these points far from here?
Nope. Should we split up?
Sure. I'll take those two there. Thanks. All full up. Can't carry any more. Impossible. I can't carry any more. Yeah.
There's a three-stepped edge on one side that looks to have been carved by hand. Interesting. The other edge is roughly broken, like it's been shattered. This is only a piece of something larger.
Abby, how are you making out?
Almost at it. Whatever it is. You?
Look for a fragment of stone with a three-stepped edge. I found one here. I'm sure we're looking for two others.
You're the expert.
Abby, how are you making out?
Almost at it. Whatever it is. You?
Look for a fragment of stone with a three-stepped edge. I found one here. I'm sure we're looking for two others.
You're the expert.
How are you making out?
Almost at it. Whatever it is. You?
Look for a fragment of stone with a three-stepped edge. I found one here. I'm sure we're looking for two others.
You're the expert.
Thank you.
hand-carved on one side. Broken on the other. Definitely part of something larger. It's almost familiar, but I wonder.
Lara, I think I have one of those stone things here.
I've got the others.
Now what?
Now we put them together and see what your grandmother is trying to tell you.
Pilar understood Grandma better than anyone. Meet me at her place.
I was hoping Abigail would be with you.
She's on her way.
Hi, Auntie.
It's been too long, child. Oh, let me look at you. Still with the shoe, I see.
Auntie, we found something in Grandma's map.
Actually, your hair could be better too, now that I see you again. The pair of you are like tomboys out chasing after.
Auntie, please. Why did Grandma want me to have the map? I deserve to know.
Do you remember the stories your grandmother used to tell you as a child? About a magical, hidden place built by your ancestors.
Yes, but I grew up, and she grew old, and nothing magical ever happened.
But she didn't forget her promise. It's there, in your hands.
Why now?
I'm only the custodian of the map. It's up to you to discover its purpose.
Abby, I'm sure whatever is revealed in this map will lead to that hidden place and your answers. I hope so. All right, let's take a look. If we place each one of the fragments on the map where they were found, like so... That's the Chacana. The Inca Cross. It represents the three levels of existence. The upper world, the middle world, our world, and the underworld.
It also represents the things that make us human. Like the ability to love, to take action, to gain wisdom.
But if I'm remembering correctly, the center of the Chacana is said to represent Cusco, the capital of the Inca Empire. In the context of the map, we're hundreds of miles from there.
Well, there are many interpretations of the Chacana. Cusco, a portal from one world to the next. It is also said to be the Eye of God, a guardian keeping watch over us all.
So what are we looking for? I mean, this has to point to something, right? Let's take a closer look. There has to be something we're not seeing. Something... There! I thought it was a small blemish when I first saw it, but in this light, it looks like a Maya hieroglyph.
Maya? That doesn't make any sense. We are Inca. What does it say?
Hahil. It means truth.
Truth? Truth about what?
I don't know. Does this place on the map mean anything to you?
Grandma and I would sit there when she told me stories about the hidden place.
Perhaps you'll find your answers there.
Are you ready? Keep the map. I'll meet you there.
pieces looked familiar. It's not until I put them all together that I can see it. It's the Chicana. The Inca cross. There are many interpretations of the cross, debated even amongst the Inca themselves, but it's an extremely important symbol nonetheless.
Mommy?
Abby, keep your radio close. I'll stay in touch if I find anything.
Sounds good. And watch your ass in there.
You can count on that. Need to open the gate. This architecture is definitely Maya.
Grandma want me to know about this place.
Must be a way to get across. This bridge works like the last one. Got to be a way to swing that pendulum over here. Behind this pendulum could be climbed. This doesn't make any sense.
What have you got?
If I had to guess, I'd say this place is a massive forge. But on this place, it's an ancient forge. What were they crafting here? This scale, the wall behind
Sorry,
this pendulum could
be
climbed.
Much help to you there.
Gonna be quite the climb. There are statues here. Huge faces arranged in a circle around a central column. They're watching over it like sentinels. These platforms look just like those bridges.
Now I kind of wish I came with you.
Whoever was wearing this either had a splitting headache or they didn't leave at all. Wait, there's dried blood here. Seismic imaging results, 25th of November, 1983. Massive oil fields beneath the village. I have conducted a physical examination of area and can confirm this to be the case. Recommend full drill operation. Paul Veneer will be back in the black. Village expendable. Recommend stage 01 outbreak if buyout ineffectual. We cannot allow the... Strange. The report cuts off mid-sentence. Go back down to bring the platform back up. These platforms look just like those bridges. Is the missing man from Paul Veneer, killed in self-defense by Mariana Ortiz. You will not find a body, but this note instead. When I found him out, he attacked me, so I hit him on the head. It was his greed, not me, which made him dead. I'm sorry for his family that will never know his fate. If this note is discovered before I'm dead, you know where to find me. Abby... I found a note. It was written by your grandmother. She confesses to killing a man to protect herself and the village.
She calls him the missing man from Porvenir. Does that mean anything to you?
I remember when I was a little kid, there was a search. One of the workers disappeared. They never found him. Shortly after that, the last of the oil dried up, and Porvenir left. Grandma, kill that guy. My grandma.
I don't think she had a choice.
My sweet Abigail, it is time you learned the truth about your past and your responsibility for the future. You are a guardian, Abigail, as I was, as my mother was before me and hers before her, and so on and so on. All the way back to the time of Queen Abarane, the mother of multitudes. Centuries ago, she led my people from the dry death of the great drought in Guatemala to the safety of this valley. On her deathbed, she chose a guardian from her line, and the responsibilities of mother were passed on. Eventually, that gift was given to me. Now, with my death, my sweet Abigail, I pass on the responsibility of guardian to you. You already know what to do. You've been doing it all your life. You are the mother of multitudes now. Keep our story well. Looks like Abby, I've got your grandmother's journal here. She's written to you. You'll want to read it for yourself. It might be a lot to digest.
Go on, what does it say?
The short of it, you're a descendant of the Maya Queen Abarane on your grandmother's side. You're the latest in a long line of protectors that...
It shows a great journey south, from Mexico to Peru. Thousands of people following their queen, escaping mass drought.
What? Queen Abarane? Grandma is related to a Maya queen? Wait, I'm related to a Maya queen?
Yes. You're a guardian, from what your grandmother said. It's all here.
What does that mean? I'm not even Maya. This day has explaining to do.
Abby, I found a mural depicting a great journey. A Maya queen leading thousands of her people from Mexico to Peru.
Why did she lead them here?
There are many theories about what happened to the Maya. There are old favorites, invasion, civil war, collapsing trade routes. But one theory has become very popular. That the Maya civilization was ultimately doomed by a period of severe climate. All the gas clouds are visible from here.
Where'd they all go?
There's a sarcophagus here. It's beautiful. Definitely made it.
Sarcophagus? Like a coffin?
Exactly like a coffin.
I thought it was a forge.
Whoever is buried here, they were very closely tied to this place and its purpose.
See what I have to trade.
How can I help you, Lara? Everything is for sale. Except Remax drum. Enjoy it. Thank you. Good luck, Lara.
Huh?
que fue hoy?
You found the hidden place?
It was a forge, but something more as well.
Yes. It is the resting place of the Maya Queen Abarrane, the first guardian of Kwakyaku. She built the forge to construct an artifact of great power.
What artifact?
I don't know. Mariana told me that what was born from that place had long been lost. But she said the message it contained would always endure. It was a message of hope for the future.
If you knew about all this, why wouldn't you tell me?
I'm sorry, but I made a promise to Mariana.
So what? I'm supposed to accept that I'm Maya all of a sudden?
Abarrane's bloodline has been diluted over the centuries, but you are descended from her.
So what does this mean?
You're a guardian, Abigail. Like Mariana and her mother before her, all the way back to the time of Abarrane.
I can't be a guardian. I have responsibilities here.
You've been protecting this village for years. Hasn't a little bit of you always known? Felt compelled somehow? You are the keeper of the story now.
That's what Grandma used to say. She said it was her job to keep its story, to keep it safe. She promised that one day she would show me where it was, and then I'd be the keeper of its story.
She didn't forget her promise. She just had a different way of showing you.
It's so like her, isn't it? She couldn't just tell me. Had to make a treasure hunt out of it.
I loved your grandmother as if she was my own sister. But sometimes she was a gigantic pain in the ass.
Abby, I think I'll leave you two alone to talk about things. Sounds like you've got some catching up to do.
Thanks, Lara. Here, I want you to have this for all your help. And before you say anything, it's customary, so you kind of can't say no.
Thank you.
I know it sounds.
like this bridge works like the last one. This pendulum could be climbed. Work like the others. Gonna be quite the climb. These platforms look just like those bridges. That gas head probably works like the one at the entrance. Another explosion would raise the platform.
Thank you.
gonna be quite the climb.
Thank you.